Welcome to the next video in the Mastering Salesforce campaign series. In this video, we will explore five different ways you can add leads and contacts to your Salesforce campaigns. Depending on the scenario, some ways are definitely more efficient than others. If you want to add existing leads and contacts to campaigns, Salesforce reports are a great way to add people en masse. If you have a list of people that need to be cross-referenced with the existing data first, then you will need a different method to identify existing records so you don't create any duplicates. Let's hop over to Salesforce and explore the different options for adding campaign members to our campaigns. Here we are in Salesforce, and our first option for adding people to campaigns can be done right from the leader contact page. If we go to the lead page and we hover over campaign history, we'll see that there's an add to campaign button, and we can select whichever campaign we want. And then we'll select the status and then we'll click save. So this is how you can add leads and contacts one by one right from the leader contact page. You'll just need to make sure that you have the campaign history related list on the page layout. The second way that you can add people to a campaign is you can use a list view. So we'll hop over to the contacts tab, and we've got a tab here called My Customer Contacts. Now we want to add all of these contacts into our prospecting campaign so that our BDR can reach out to these people to call them. I have this list view filtered exactly the way I want it. So this is showing all of the contacts that I own with the account status of customer. If there's any other additional filters that you'd want to add to this list view, you can add those here. And then I can select the contact in the first row, hold the shift key down, and then select all the way through row 8, and that will select everybody in between if you only want to select subsets of these people based on maybe how you sort it. Now you can only add 200 people at a time using a list view, but this can be a great way that you can add people to a campaign in one step. You just select the campaign, the member status. If it finds these people already exist in the campaign, you can tell it to overwrite the member status or keep it. I'm gonna say keep existing member status here, just in case somebody else added them and they have a different status. And now I have added all of those 8 people to my 2023 Prospecting New Computer Model campaign. The third way that you can add people to a campaign is by using a report. We have an all unconverted leads report here, and we can add everybody to a campaign by clicking the dropdown, clicking add to campaign, select your campaign and the status, and you will again be asked if you want to overwrite the existing campaign member status in case these people already exist in the campaign. Now, one thing about the report add to campaign feature is it's all or nothing. You cannot select a subset of these people. You have to use the report filters to filter down to the exact list of people that you want in this campaign. Once you click submit, it's going to start a job and it will start running to add all these people into the campaign, and you'll receive an email confirmation once all of these people are added. I'm going to click cancel out of here, and I'm going to show you the fourth way that you can add people to a campaign. Our fourth way involves exporting this list. So I'll click the drop down here, I'm going to export this into a CSV, and I'll open this up in Excel. Now you can see that I have my lead ID in my report here. So you want to make sure that you have your lead ID in your report when you export it, because you will use that for matching. Here's what my report looks like. So you would do whatever work you need to do on this list to remove whoever you don't want to import. So I'll remove 5 of these people here. I will save this. We'll close out of here. And then we're going to go to our campaign and we're going to use the data import wizard. We'll go to the 2023 Prospecting New Computer Model campaign, because this is the one we're adding all of our members to. I'm going to hover over campaign members, and then I will click the drop down and I will select import leads and contacts. My list contains a list of leads, so I will select leads there. And I am going to say I'm going to update existing records, and I want to match by my salesforce.com ID. I will also say that I want to assign the leads to campaigns during the import. And then I don't need to select anything else here. I will then drag and drop my CSV onto here. Click next, and I need to map my lead ID. And then it doesn't really matter if any of these other fields are mapped or not, because I did a direct export from my report. And then I can see that I have 6 fields mapped, 1 unmapped, which is okay. And then I'll start the import. I'll click okay. And then this starts a job in Salesforce, and it will let you know when it's done. And you'll also get an email when it's done as well. We just received our email letting us know that the job has completed. We're going to review this bulk data load job page that tells us the results of the job. We can see that one of the records failed of the 146 that were processed. Now this job is for the lead object. Whenever you're running an import on the data import wizard, it is doing multiple jobs if you're adding people to the campaign as well. So the first job is going to be into the object that you're importing it in, whether it's leads or contacts, and then the second one will be the campaign member. To view why the one record failed, you'll click the view result, and then you'll open up the file in Excel. You can open it up here, and we can see that we have an issue with our lead. There's an issue with the country, so that's why this one failed. So we'll close our files out. Now we'll take a look at our second job by going back to the bulk data jobs list, and we can see that our second job here was on the campaign member. We have 2 failed records there, and we can click into this job ID and then click view result to view why these 2 records failed. Now, one of the records are going to fail due to that one error that we received on our leads. And then we can also see we have another error that somebody is already a campaign member. So you would need to go in and look at that lead and manually add them to the campaign in order to fix the one that failed. We'll now head back to our campaign, and we'll go check out and make sure that we can see all of the campaign members. So we can see we have 146 leads. That's great. So we have everybody from our file, minus the one that failed. And then we also have our 8 contacts. So that's a 4th way that you can add campaign members into a campaign. Keep in mind that Data Import Wizard only allows you to add 50,000 records at a time. Now, if you need to add more than 50,000, you will need to use Data Loader. That's going to bring us to our 5th way to add campaign members, is using good old-fashioned Data Loader. Now, we have a really great video that we just did called Mastering Salesforce Campaigns: How to Import People Without Creating Duplicates. This video walks you through step-by-step how to take a list that you get from a trade show or an event and cross-reference it with your existing records in Salesforce. Shows you how to match up contacts, how to match up accounts, and then how to match up leads. You ultimately end up with 4 different groups of people, with existing contacts, net new contacts that go under existing accounts, existing leads, and then net new leads. We'll walk you through how to match up all of that, cross-reference it using VLOOKUP, and then at the end, you will add all of those 4 different types of people to the campaign using Data Loader. Now, we have a file that we've already prepared for our event in Australia. I wish. It's not real, but one day. Here we have a file that shows our leads and our contacts that we want to add to our campaign that is tracking our Australian event. We can see that we have a column for our lead ID, a column for our contact ID, campaign ID, and then our campaign member status. You do not need to specify the campaign member status if all of your campaign members are just going to have the default status of the campaign. So if we come over here to Salesforce and we look at the BTA conference in Australia, we can see that we have 4 different statuses, and our default status is on attendee list. In the Excel file that we prepared, our campaign members have statuses of visited booth, attended, or had a meeting. So we need to specify these since we want them to be updated accordingly. Now you'll see here that you can import leads and contacts at the same time into Salesforce as campaign members. You're just going to put them in separate columns, just like this. You'll save this file as a CSV. Then you'll go over to Data Loader. We will run an insert. You're going to have to click Show All Salesforce Objects. We'll select Campaign Member. And we have 49 people that are going to go into this campaign. We're going to map our fields. I'm going to drag our status down there so all this looks mapped perfectly. Click OK, next, finish, yes. You can see that we have 49 successful inserts, and now we'll come back and we'll refresh our campaign. You can see that we have 27 leads and 22 contacts. And then we can see here that everybody was imported with the appropriate status. And then we can review our report over here, refresh it, and then we should see our counts by status for this particular campaign. All right, those are the five different ways that you can add campaign members to your campaigns in Salesforce. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on that will show you how to further use the campaign object in Salesforce. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you would like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.